Welcome, everyone. Hey, we even have... Oh, yeah, I forgot. 24 hours not in the office and you check forgot. Forgot to check. Pulse audio. Anyway, welcome, everyone, to another late night Linux, the show, only live here on this channel. As you see, we have our precious SG Octane turned on. That is our syncing here also, three keyboards, obviously previous videos, because also Sunblade stuff, and hey, and we synced this, amazing. I'm just a little bit wondering, maybe I actually, you know what, I could have been more smarter, but you know, that doesn't, well, first of all, a recurring theme, not smart. And because I was just thinking, I don't have a second VGA port because the sun does somehow not come up. That is a recurring something, it's a little bit meh. But actually, I have here a second 13W3 cable. Let me just plug this into the second display. So let's see, because the Sunblade, oh wait a second, this is the wrong display, it's this display. What is with the, what, no media font? I never had that though. Why is this happening? Yeah, we have even a, why would that happen? I don't remember. Well, it could, anyway, can we, let's restart, let's follow the boot there. This is a funny thing, the Sunblade 1000 has one tiny glitch, beside it's not booting for me with all the memory in. Theoretically, I got it with 8 gigs, but somehow with 8 gigs it doesn't boot, because obviously reasons. But the second thing is that this piece, two compatible keyboard somehow glitches there something with come on, I hate the still display, this is the worst display shit ever. Yeah, so Sunblade 1000, let's maybe press okay, USB does yeah, so USB is, if I have this USB keyboard, this Philco Myest Touch thing there with PS2 emulation, then the firmware is also not happy. So something is with the USB ports in regards to old-fashioned PS2 physical emulation thing. This is asynchronous login fails. This is really bizarre, because which kernel did we even, I booted so often, only live on this channel, maybe I should. Yeah, the funny thing is, I thought I switch both on, the Blade and the Octane, to avoid exactly this hiccup of boot hiccup during the live stream, and then it has other boot hiccups. Let's just plug out the USB cable and continue with Octane for now. Maybe it whatever is, whatever. Anyway, so Octane, I'm curious, as per the previous videos, we cross-compiled Firefox. And the only thing is, due to the nature of Rust and Cargo, not only might it not start, Let's start X. That should theoretically work. So last time I left my impact driver, also the precious SGI-like PS2 mouse. And so for this we use the old system as so often. And yes, you don't see this. You don't see this yet. I will zoom in as soon as the sunblade is up. So basically just bind mounted, this is bind mount this proc here into our new rsynced this root and root also of root change root in here. And so far so good. The big change is for this latest build that it is not N32 anymore because Rust doesn't support it, or Rust and LLVM. So wonderful, my sunblade doesn't come up. This is hilarious. It was working recently. Okay, fine. All right. Then this is a SGI only live stream because the sunblade fails on me. But yeah, old rotating magnetic fiber channel stuff, whatever is. Also, this is strange. Is this because actually it boots from that? Maybe Linux kernel timing bug of whatever sorts. You probably get the idea. Anyways, to zoom in here a little bit. Again, could have used the screen capture, but then. Anyway, it's mostly testing and hanging out, so. Bear with me in case this is anyway certainly not readable, but probably I also need an even more professional video capture thing. Anyway, it might crash and burn anyway faster than not, and then we need to check what's up with our sunblade. But yeah, vintage stuff, don't buy it overpriced on eBay because usually it fails on you faster than sooner. So nearly everything built, I had to do some tiny little corrections as per usual, cross build and MIPS stuff and so on. They already committed in T2. That's so we need etc post install, we need shared MIME info at least, and also LD config. And then let's hope this works. Then shared MIME info, okay, that works. And yeah, I could probably optimize this experience by. No, that is not what I want. Can we? There is an ISO, probably. Yeah, whatever, you get the idea. If this comes up, the chances are 50-50 or less than 50-50. Also, fun fact, although MIP64 has a JIT compiler implementation, unlike Spark and PowerPC, or ironically, right, PowerPC should at this point of time in last decade more popular than MIPS, but whatever. GTK, and then we theoretically also have, always have so much to do. GTK3 demo, let's see if this comes up or crashes. This is always what unrecognized image format, so core dump, nah, this usually is shared MIME info, so. We also have one S trace or log of E open at or something. But why can this often crash? Because yeah, we are at times nearly the only people left testing this, and miscompilation of stuff. So here's some icon cache. Does it want icon cache? Does it crash on icon cache? There's also this GDK. Here's this, by the way. So this is what I wanted, and yes, this is already the fifth time I fixed this here. Or post-install mkdir parent directory that, and then rmdir the last thing, and GDK pixbuff query into that. And let's see if this fixes already something. And again, mind you, this is only because we are doing this. So basically, this is a tiny little manual labor Obviously, I also need to adapt the. And this even comes up, so this was that crash. The fonts are also. Again, these are like three tiny little left things for this minimal Xorg ISO that is a new configured spin of T2. And yes, this is by the way live on an SG Octane, right? Dual 250 MHz in case you could run, still run this in regular distro share. Fonts LNS. X11 share fonts, and again you will not need to do this because the final ISO will have all the fixes. GTK3 demo. I test this with GTK3 demo because obviously that needs to work first because we can even try Firefox. The question is, so I've, fun fact, I've never also, yeah, how long does, I mean, hey, it freaking works, right? T2, unsuccessful Wurman distribution, all architectures kind of nearly. Anyway, can we also click on this? But yeah, how fast is this stuff? It's like, yeah, scrolling like, but to be fair, it's a somewhat unisolated impact driver. Does here also something come up? Or Flowerbox, hello? Okay, fine, we don't need this demo stuff, whatever. The only thing we are really interested are opt, although we can also just Firefox. So it can crash, maybe it does not crash, maybe it comes up. And if this comes up, illegal instruction, okay. I somewhat expected that, at least illegal instruction. I have the suspicion that could be in the Java engine because probably this only supports some newer variant. So warp, as per usual, JDB, so theoretically does this file core dump. Do you see that somewhat? Maybe not really, huh? Of actually, this has been Firefox interesting. JDB Firefox core, does it work like this or does it need a full parse? Yeah, even JDB, so it's somewhat disappointing. It is honestly the first time I also, yeah, how long does it take for JDB to load this on a dual 250 megahertz RISC R10000? And so. To see the illegal instructions, this is similar to what I had on Power 5. This would be what I usually use. Of course, there certainly are a lot of ways, including disassembly, no? Anyway, what I usually use is layout ASM. And so what does it even, this is strange. It doesn't even disassemble this instruction. Because this should be the current instruction and that is just some 7. See, maybe with my experience it could be different things. Also no screen suspense. Layout, what is it? Is it that Q for quit set? That could simply be a little versus big engine. For example, could be that this MIP65 stuff was only ever tested with little endianess. It is entirely in this libxul, so it could also be it could still be as it's in this libxul. I'm not sure if it's linking JavaScript into that though, but yeah, what I don't quite get is that by default, it certainly doesn't have debug symbols because I usually don't waste 1 GB of debug symbols for this fun stuff. It also, I also find it strange that in the spec trace, this JDB should it not have the entry points, should it not be able to at least decode the, yeah, I can write, I zoomed out for it. You should it not be able to at least decode the function names, but yeah, what do I know? We probably need to do this better in our own system. So yeah, warp more a little bit. It could also be that this is intentional. It could be that this is in a board similar to the ICU. Also, I think that I left out var ADM logs. Oh no, I didn't leave out the logs. So then we can view where this cross-compiled thing with IC. All right, you know what this is? I take this back. Ah, darn. This is the ICU stuff. Oh, I'm so stupid. I'm so stupid. You're literally watching the dumbest IT YouTuber in all of YouTube history. Yesterday's video. Maybe this is an intentional trap, as in like intentional illegal instruction. I thought it could be throwing an exception for this ICU init failed, because I didn't have figure out. I actually thought let's rebuild that with not system ICU. Actually, I thought I built it with built an ICU, because I have not yet figured out cross compiling this ICU stuff. It's similar, not as amazingly configured, just as Firefox so much too. But anyway, it took half of the day to emerge that anyway, the whole system, because I am with our testing expertise and stuff. I actually tried out to build MIPS 64 and 32 with 32-bit pointers for performance, obviously, as we need the last 5 performance on this. And so yeah, not that much time is wasted. I fat fingers in my navigation cluster. Job Firefox. Let's rebuild Firefox. And the good thing is on this also tmux is first. Target. MIPS, the same probably then goes Firefox. The same then probably goes for Spark, which I wanted to equally test. Spark cross. Oh, wait a second. Not sure. Let's see. Due to the nature of Rust and Cargo, maybe it's with 32. I think IOLO says something of not rebuilding some stuff. I have the feeling I probably have the same system ICU thing then, yeah. So then let's, yeah. So much to that, but there is hope. While we build this, we have multiple things to do. Firefox. And welcome everyone. Obviously, let's also start our amazing activity viewer, because I just rebooted testing in the latest 5.9.1 Linux kernel, which obviously I also already committed today. So we could now either work on the details of adapting some post-install stuff of JDK stuff and so on, but we could also just get our Ultra Spark 1000 to boot there. So welcome everyone. I think Dave is configuration on this S-string. See how tell as this configuration on the S-string is interesting to see how low Firefox can run. Yeah. So this is CPU wise dual 250 megahertz. This is a faster of the 2 octanes. Previous video, I fun fact got this for free, but not even due to my YouTube stuff. Literally everyone. Which build is that? I think I somehow YOLO'd this config. This is not a real error, this is just. That I somehow started the build without regenerating the config, and then I think I had hand edited this to 32 just to avoid rebuilding half of the system, which will of course not happen the next time. So yeah, it's mostly limited, except we don't have an isolated X driver yet, and somehow we have I have the feeling we need to restart. Yeah, somehow the Linux USB stack is irritated. Let me restart OBS, and usually the USB capture speaker is faster, whatever. Or you know what, let's just leave it running I restart OBS because it triggers myself. Yeah, at least right now just restarting nothing. Okay, yeah. Anyway, although I noticed that sometimes it's the preview speed. I noticed in some videos that I thought were a little bit lagging the YouTube when I later watched it myself. Reviewing my own quality stuff and thinking of what I could do. better and so on. There's a usual quality assurance here. I think the YouTube stream is at times better than that. So let's, while we're so mostly CPU limited, obviously, let's switch on the Sunblade. I really wanted this never happened. Did I break something? I don't really remember breaking something. The last time I turned it on, it did work. Yeah, so much to your vintage collection. And there's always something. Although I never had this USB 3 keyboard on there. Maybe let's... I probably really need to have a better kind of cinematographic setup here. Better views anyway. But yeah, we need to fix up so much stuff that didn't have time to redecorate the office. So that's what you got. So let's see what happens this time without the keyboard plugged in. I still have hope that this is just some strange timing stuff. Maybe I should actually invest into a SCA, not SCA, into a fiber channel SSD. There are some, not the cheapest, but not the most expensive used ones on eBay. Although the question is, of course, first of all, will it be compatible enough? And second of all, how much wear leveling have they already? It's of course, would be a shame to spend some good money on some fiber channel SSD stuff and then it is already 100% used in a data center. Did this... Oh no, this is probably... Yeah, but this is somewhat ridiculous that live on this channel always some stuff fails. This is really strange. I think login failed. I literally did nothing. Well, I moved it. I mean, I moved it 5 centimeters without even switching it off. That is hilarious. I'm not quite sure what I should make out of that, though. This is... But yeah, maybe I need a nice rack behind me for all the machines and then... But even the thing with auto reboot, first of all, not all stuff has auto in an Ethernet wake up. For example, the IBM RS6000 has a line of advertisement for that in the manual, like one line, some asterisk somewhere of Ethernet wake up stuff, and then it never mentions it anyway. I also googled, I found nothing of IBM AIX Power PC RS6000 stuff, 6K stuff of Ethernet wake up. Also Octane maybe not. And there's so much to that, so probably if I would have a fully automated test rack, probably that would require soldering some opto-isolated switching stuff on some stuff. Or actually fully maybe configure them so that they power on power and fully switch off the power to the machine, which probably is better for the standby power and aging power supplies anyway. So let's see, falling back to so NVRAM, it's not yet asynchronous login failed. How fast was it the last time? I've done nothing else than switching it off and on again and pulling the USB-C cable. No, async login failed. This is hilarious. Why the heck? This is so sad. The problem is, I don't even want to probably show the right thing. Microphone cable is also too short. So what I found, so power cycles is again, I want to try because usually I had this USB keyboard in, who knows what. I also could, if we would have a USB keyboard, I could change the kernel. What I found is, so if I have this, if you may or may not see this PS2 compatible keyboard in there because it is using the USB, my previous FPGA video with the Ulex 3S and FPGA. So, I didn't move the camera too much. So I found like plugging it in later because probably the electric signaling on that port, the voltages, maybe there is no something. Or I need to find the serial cable. Yeah, the problem is if we don't have... Oh, my life on this channel, what... I really wonder though, but yeah, also recurring theme and why I usually advise not to buy overpriced stuff there on eBay. Could also suspend this until I have the UltraSpark, why do we not have signal now? Should it not have? And now we have. Yeah, so this is exactly, maybe USB cable is bad there. Oh, wait a second, this is. But anyway, do we get. Anyway, it says asynchronous login failure. Yeah, but this kind of bugs drive one crazy, us and customers. You use it, and then it fails. Where do I have my USB cable? I was already looking for that the other day. Or here is maybe something. What is that? Is this my... What is this here even? Anyway, maybe I suspend this here shortly. Only to boot until the which cable is it here even? Oh, so this is an unused USB extension. Fun fact, too much crap on my desk. Probably I suspend the stream shortly until I got the Spark running. This is of course really hilarious. Also, I have the do you think having an SGI octane standing on this Sunblade 1000 might influence its EMC, electromagnetic interference stuff. Anyway, let's grab a USB cable so that I have a better boot control stuff. Let's maybe try a slightly different cable, or I lift the octane over and place the octane on the G5. Anyway, see you in some minutes. Still. build ID with 16 reads. What do you mean build ID with 16? What you even saying? Anyway, I suspend this shortly and see you in a bit when this sun is up and running. Also, it complains about. Oh, maybe. Anyway, see you in a minute. So, we are live again, not sure how. Also, now my Siri cable is. So, and the good old fashioned Siri console. Let's try to. Which was the other. Darn. There was some days. Shit. Yeah, if we would not have a comma key, let's maybe try that. And because, I mean, this was booting before. That was 585, 58. Not sure which of them was there. What though? This is also hilarious. You boot 100 times. No, it worked. Look at that. Wait a second. This always says asynchronous login. So the kernel panic already got a couple of times. It was. Do I have the USB cable in this? Somehow, I thought it's a random memory thing, but later I found it would usually happen. Whatsoever. Okay, so there goes that theory. I had the theory that this only happens with the USB thing in. So yeah, there's also so then this. I may present to you the next. Oh wait a second. This is. But this is, wait a second, this is not related to KVD rate, or is it? What? Spark this core, wait a second, this is something else than kernel bucket, kernel CPU, what? Don't tell me this KVD rate. Is there something that is not? Anyway, in case you were wondering why. I want my own microkernel that doesn't randomly crash and panic. That doesn't like something. There is no, yeah, for whatever reason. Okay, the other thing, so anyway, so this message then is printed always. Didn't remember that. And we could theoretically boot for our precious. There is no our too many USB cables. That is our nice keyboard. Oh, wait a second. I wanted to use this nice keyboard. This nice keyboard was meant for the Sun. This also doesn't have USB emulation. But one thing is for sure, it heats nicely the office now. It's certainly not a Friday for Futures episode here in terms of spinning electrons through vintage high power Unix machines. But at least it heats the office. But yeah, at least I was not making up that this stuff was booting previously before we got this random stuff. Maybe I should actually I didn't even pay too close attention, but we had this, so this KBD rate was also failing on Hewlett-Packard Precision Architecture. I wonder if other distributions, you know what, maybe for the sake of better stability of a single dress brace monolithic Linux kernel, not to run this. Did I plug in the other keyboard into the Octane? Probably not. Nah. so much to that. Yeah, in case you were wondering why one needs, by the way, how much is a frame rate? Is this preview? This is funny, is this? Well, whatever. Preview wise, why? Oh, wait a second, did we boot already or. No, I was actually not watching that because. Because I was fiddling with some keyboard. Yeah, looks, but now we have this keyboard so we can reboot there in case I don't need to stand up and plug that in and out. Maybe let's, for better scenery, we could. Where is ISO? That's not ISO, that's not ISO. For more matching scenery, we could switch the ISO to, is that better? Maybe not as bright as the other. By the way, those people who are watching right now, you could, which are some, which is also amazing. Welcome everyone to this random vintage Unix live stream here. By the way, now this scene is even slightly better because I. By the way, do we boot already? Maybe I should concentrate more on our boot. Scenery is somewhat better because I moved the octane. Oh, by the way, does this have an effect? Because I moved the octane on the G5R. Did we boot here already? Maybe I should pay closer attention to what we actually do on the systems. Oh, did we boot so fast that. Ah, you know what? We don't see this here now because. Nah, this is why I didn't see this. I was already wondering what's going on there. Because now we don't have Siri console because it auto defaults. It needs. As soon as it has an USB keyboard, which is also why with this keyboard, if because this PS2 emulation negotiation stuff. Confuses, or actually old-fashioned resistors or so, confuses this USB port bring up there on the sun. So that is why with this USB PS2 keyboard you don't get the we don't have, why do not have USB here? That is, come on. Okay, fine, I wanted to type there init equals bin bash, no, we don't have that because reasons. Yeah, and how you can reboot after reboot. I mean, the good thing is we need here some 30 minutes to rebuild. Firefox for Spark 64 and that, so. This is really curious why in. Some combination, this doesn't come up now. Strange stuff. So let's try this again then with serial console. I mean, in general, for remote reproducibility and stuff that is somewhat so. Linux init equals bin bash. That hopefully should give us a shell where I comment out the. KBD rate to maybe get away of the strange. Maybe this crashes this auto keyboard. I can't make this bugs up. Maybe that crashes, oopses the kernel with, or do we have, does it need, don't tell me it, oh god, good. Thankfully that worked without, not that we need init, console equals tt. Why something so mount, remount, read write, and then etc init system also kbd rate. So this is not so slow, not because it's a freaking, or is it an own init script of kbd, or yep, it actually is. It's of course only so slow because 9600 baud. Yeah, so that is that. KBD rate. Let's just comment that out. That probably should be fine, hopefully. Remount read only and exec spin init. Let's see what happens. Yeah, I mean, thankfully not, you know, that, so did this stray can't make this stuff up. I thought this is some hardware glitch stuff. I did never really pay that close attention, but no, KBD rate, the more you know. But yeah, also 2020 KBD rate can oops you or Hewlett Packard or Spark 64 kernel, because apparently no good reasons. Anyway, let's see if we probably should have a login there on that. Yeah, Blade Runner login. That works. I only need to, probably as long as we tinkered around there now. Firefox is also compiled for hopefully second test soon. And probably also time for last. Yeah, but this is also to document how much overhead is. Can you just quickly test something, and then half an hour is gone. I mean, half an hour rearranging the machines, getting it from the corner, plugging in everything in, powering up, then it doesn't boot, and this and that, and so on. So let's. What do we have here on screen? We have that on screen. Also, I didn't want this. Can this? This is VGA. So here we have this precious. Do I have here like test? I have here like test. I think X has a chance to come up. At least I think I left it so that it should come up. And yeah, isn't that a beautiful, also by the way, I think this is bloody stretching it. I really wish this stupid, yeah, this is fill. I want by default a spec, but somehow this bloody Dell displays of a decade ago. Also don't want to remember that. So you probably don't see it the most, and I don't see what I show you, although I certainly could move that there so that at least I see what I show you. Also keyboard rate, no, bit rate. Anyway, let's rsync stuff over. I probably, by the way, I really like this, like, not PC, but new, this probably, I really like this beep. Usually the beep is like, this is really like a really, like, quality, like, royal beep of quality beepness. Let's see, rsync 130 stuff, that probably could be correct. And this password is one I can't show you, or shouldn't, anyway. I hope I didn't show you that, did I? I hope not. Oh, I think I didn't. So yeah, this is rsyncing, but okay, it's rsyncing Firefox, but this is anyway not the last version. We're still compiling here, as you might see here. But then yeah, another appraiser where we can already update our to-do, which I have not done yet because ICU4C cross data files, or did I probably not add this here? The irony is, like, if we patch this our way, then it doesn't work in upstream Firefox, but for us, but our other package anyway needs some more guidance for that. Also, we have theoretically some, not like really release stopper, but MIPS64 crypto setup and flag, I think. Something of that sort. This probably should come to an end. Ah, yeah, it's already LTO or Rust. Obviously Rust, 4 minutes Rust, because Rust. I wonder, the web renderer is still not the default, right? I'm not sure if we rsync that there. I'm still not sure if... this was already correct. Whether... we just finished that. Which one is it? This is MIP64. Then Spark. Then let's switch it to the Precious Octane. That is that keyboard. Let's rsync that again. That is that mouse. That is too tiny, but it's only rsync. What counts should be the result profile of rsync. So that is rsync, this MIP stuff all again. And 1 second of... So the difference is for testing purposes only non-system ICU. Just because we debugged and yoloed that around, that at least it works in Firefox. But for pure perfection and attention to details, we need to fix this for non-Firefox build real system ICU. Anyway, another day. But for now, I'm just curious if this has any chance to come up. I also wanted to say, in the previous stream I forgot, with like best practices and the situation of Mozilla, not... So by the way, did I done? I should have only rsynced. Anyway, now we need to redo. I also think this shouldn't like segmentation fault. It should like also system like software development in 2020. This stuff really should print out a message and not segmentation fault. It's just like Unicode stuff failed. Maybe it should even do gracefully and continue without Unicode support, but. Yeah, let's test JDK 3 because we unfortunately rsynced everything, so maybe overwriting files, but I think the fonts, so yeah, the new cached files are still there. And Firefox, let's keep our, we press thumbs, you somehow cross the fingers, but yeah, still illegal instruction. Unfortunately, we rsynced this, so this is, however, the right version, JDK. Do we have anything else that... Well, it could still be... I think... Maybe we actually control... Also, yeah, this stuff is relatively stable, right? We can have a relatively... Well, so much sophisticated stuff running. MIP64 on T2. Let's see. This probably should be a synced log, shouldn't it, of var ADM Firefox, yeah. Also, this was not the jobs I wanted. I don't have that. Of Big Endian, we need a Big Endian. No. Patch. No, Big Endian diff that was applied. So, and system ICU. Then there is still something else. So then, anyway, we will see this in just a second. on the spark while we still load the core dump, because obviously. So let's see, the Spark 64 version of course also built. Then let's switch to that display there. That would be that. And see what happens with OSPark. But previously, version 15 that once upon a time worked. Let's, what do I show? We show that somewhat. But again, this is only rsync, and rsync all this stuff over here. And then you also, this picture is exactly where the rsync is running, certainly not ideal for this. Nothing we can fix on the fly. So, also here, yeah, some low refresh rate, but we don't have mode setting for the Creator FB. Bind mount all the stuff, or did we bind mount this previously? Proc? Probably not, right? We mounts of. No. So, bind mount. Proc this div, and darn, is it not a complete build? Is here whatever, not sure. Anyway, so GTK 3 demo will most likely not come up. Let's see, we probably need to do the usual stuff that we... Oh no, this actually comes up. Maybe because we previously tested with the other Firefox. So good to know, then we need to fiddle less around. Let's keep our fingers crossed and thumbs pressed for that fun stuff. It's still working. So, I mean, given that the CPUs are faster, we still get something. And segmentation fault. Nah. So... What more, so much efforts and stuff. Well, it starts more, but still segmentation faults. In case you were wondering. So this is also in libxul, but libthreads, and most likely, well, not most likely, I definitely need this with debug symbols. Also it has some signal handler, but yeah, stuff to do. There could be sandboxing broken. There could be all kind of things broken. But this is really set. I just want to see if this JDK pixbuff stuff works fully also somehow. Do we not have somehow a mouse wheel of... No. Can't even click the small scroll bar thing there in 2020. JDK is OpenGL area. Yeah, but this is really sad. I really had hoped that because it's compiled now that it also had some chance. Right, do we not have to click there? Hello? Scrubber? Oh, no, did it? Why does this is so slow? How can this be that slow? Okay, some of this is really slow. No, but this, there's some huge delay where this is frozen for some strange reason. Runs smoothly, then freezes. Well, no, it's quiet. Anyway, whatever. Follow children, overlock, opt, fire, opt, Mozilla bin, Firefox, let's see. But yeah, this is really sad, obviously, for all the efforts spent here on both platforms, but certainly what is to be expected on something not really maintained by too many other people. IPDL protocol, there's also protocol area error, member of cloned message data. So yeah, there is some, maybe this might be the most likely, wait a second, is it, let's maybe run this without asterisk and see if we get the same stuff. This is really sad. I really had hoped, like, hey, we have Firefox running. But yeah, this is my life, 20 years, getting stuff to compile and then this documentation fault. Yeah, so this is still happening. IPDL protocol error, deserializing data structure, cloned buffer member of cloned message data, accepting to due to channel errors. I slightly wonder if we can build without sandboxing. Let's switch to that. And where's also, all right, maybe I probably have, where do we even have this live streaming? Oh, here, obviously. I wonder if we can build, if this is sandboxing or not. IPC of, actually I had here if this, this and that, then otherwise disable IPC. This would cover Spark, but I think this option didn't work anymore. We can try this, but I'm pretty sure this errors out in less than a minute due to option unknown. Yeah, somewhat said what exactly was the, let's see. Yeah, really sad. But not that unexpected. Firefox IPDL protocol error, returned error code of still not out, IPDL valent file descriptor. This is even on, is this Windows NT? So yeah, probably invalid option error of Z. I slightly wonder if IPC, does it still support sandbox disablement IPC of, we could try that for a change. I think we saw another live stream that one needs to recompile this. It's unfortunately maybe for security or something, not a, build time option. Yeah, disable sandbox. Let's see. To disable building the sandbox completely, built with that. We could give it a try while we do other things. Yeah, also, I mean, here, this is the, do you, probably that should be on screen. Otherwise, also, what is the other backtracer, right? We had this. All right, illegal instruction of layout ISM. I think it's still the same. Let's try to s trace fo lock Firefox, but elegant instruction, what did it do last, of open CPU info, it opened CPU info. Well, it could be JavaScript and it could be that needs MIP 64, something like some newer revision. Because we have only MIPs 1, 2, 3, 4 versus R10K. Yeah, let's shut down H, I think. MIP 64 we will not continue today. And Spark64V might give one more try without sandbox and see what happens there. Violet, it's also here. Welcome everyone. To disable, so the Graver just jumped in. Disable sandbox, I did disable just right, I just read this morning. Afternoon, yeah, welcome everyone. Thanks for the greetings. So this was the octanes. Let's also plug out. Comes from lifting it onto the G5. Only here we stack octanes on G5s. This came out because I don't want to ruin this power supply, this standby power stuff. What we theoretically should do, so yeah, this unfortunately as per usual takes 20 minutes or something of that sort. What we could do while at it, well, we theoretically we have two build errors on MIP64. One is flag, sorry. Do I drink another coffee? Okay, maybe I shouldn't drink another coffee. How long did we live stream? Probably with all this random interruption, probably already easily 1 hour. And yeah, in general, this is what we do here. If you're new to this channel, a good old fashioned and all the non-x86 stuff. What you probably want to share, like, and subscribe for, and usually a little bit more sorted than this. This is just like after a week of work, finally disappointedly testing this stuff. I think flag failed and also crypto setup failed. Let's one crypto setup or crypt setup. Maybe. And our CPU is already busy. It's somewhat said that both of those don't work. We could do if we want, you know what, if we want also, yeah, because we also have MIPS little endiness here. But now we already built enough. There we could test whether that is a... I wonder though whether this is a JavaScript engine thing. I slightly wonder, does it have an option for Firefox disable JavaScript? Not JavaScript, JIT. Disable JIT, JITless, OpenBSD. So I know running Chromium JITless, can Firefox JIT disable for a script based on JIT and not disabled and unsupported? What is here? Build drop support for x86 without SSE2. Disable Ion. If people want to run Firefox on ancient hardware, they can compile with disable Ion and use a non-big and no JITs. Honestly, don't think it's worth the time and resources. We could actually give that a try for MIPS, because that is surprise surprise building with a JIT compiler, and surprise surprise that could easily break with using Atomic and other new instructions, and or maybe latest MIPS even has branches without delay slots or stuff like this, and of course they need to use them to not support older MIPS CPUs. Let's just put it in there and rebuild this, and let's see what are we also disabled sandbox. Let's just put it here for testing purposes for other CPU stuff. Disable Ion. Let's see if that does something. We can never have too many Tmaxes off. But hey, at least it builds, even if it crashes. So let's see what happens with this flag stuff. Also, yeah, fun fact, everything builds also. You could tell me how slow this video view there is, because my preview is super, super lagging. Which somehow was... Nah, whatever, that's the most important. So it fails with, because somehow stuff always fails, so file in wrong format, so libm. I slightly wonder how that happens. So we built for N64, and so this is obviously the wrong libm. Maybe this is some libtool amazingness. Is it using libtool? Does it look like libtool? What could we do for that? Also, yeah, this is libtool because it's .la files for libtool archive stuff. Yeah, it's always so amazing to see what amazing stuff can happen. Sometimes we can, well, we could use our compiler wrapper to transform the stuff away. We could also, also maybe, I don't know if run this wrong with this comment. We might also libtool equals, sometimes using some other libtool fixes stuff. Okay, this does not fix that. Let's try root toolchain tools cross bin libtool. This also doesn't, this apparently does it use the wrong GCC. Okay, this is doing even worse stuff. We could use our, is it running with, question is it linking with LD, or, you know, we could test this with GCC wrapper debug equals one. Also, by the way, does it build without ion? Does it disable JIT? Ion is deprecated. So yeah, it's error, it's deprecated, but it's an error. It's like, yeah. Man, can't mix this. Also, if yeah, also you could just let this continue, but fine, we can also. But also, yeah, recurring theme, if you were wondering, is it's a one-time thing that they constantly need to change stuff. No, they constantly need to change stuff because otherwise life wouldn't be such a depressive nightmare. So this is the run here, and it's running GCC with, you know what? This is the wrong library passing for, I slightly wonder, I don't directly see, oh, what SSE2, why is it here? But maybe these files are empty, but no, amazing. What AVX2 on MIP64, what the heck? But maybe the files are hopefully empty of ifdef x86 something. Can we, we can't select that. I wonder, should it not skip this dir? We could for test var append gcc wrapper remove. Does this, of course it doesn't correctly. Now we probably have some newline garbage in there. Let's see if that does something. It probably removed that now. Copy, 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 conditional. Removed all three, no. No, it's still here though. Have we done var append gcc wrapper remove? Do we have done here something stupid? Is it in the remove flex of? Should remove that though. -l something, why is it still in there? What am I overlooking? Well, it's not the most, but yeah, it builds for everything except that is always a little bit. Oh, here's user RV. Maybe we transform this ourselves. Maybe this is transformed from this actually, this is why it's maybe not removed, because our wrapper is transforming it to adding the prefix. Let's see what happens now. Okay, that works. So, but it is interesting that should the linker not continue with the right. So anyway, I think this is fully built now. So yeah, so this lip thing is an issue as per usual. GCC wrapper. Maybe we can make this, what would this be, wrapper. What do we have here for remove or? Maybe this is probably filter. It's probably matching here something of that sort. So the problem is that this is translating user stuff. I wonder. Maybe it would fix more stuff if we automagically, if I make this two regular expressions for include and lip and transform the lip to the actual lip dir. Maybe we could, yeah, making T2 even better. I mean, not like it would already be the best distribution out there. Some people might have noticed, but also what is here now? Crypt, also script setup, also Firefox builds this. What is the issue with crypt setups? Also, maybe we just finish that first. Or, yeah, let's see what it is. But everything else, I think nearly everything except some small stuff and some stuff was already known. Some tiny little imperfections here and there. Crypt setup of Z-error, what is that of? Maybe this is, you know what, maybe this is a similar thing here of lip tool of, this looks pretty similar. If we are lucky, this could be the same thing. So this is probably a generic wrapper transform here in GCC. Include, and of course it probably is our path link of this or this SED. And what is this opt include lip? Why are here two different things? Include or lip and include or lip. This is too rude and this is not really, probably should have documented myself though. Ah, this is our password. Why do we have here two? Ah, this is I. So this is only I for include, but why, wait a second, if this is only include, why do we have lip here? This here is only dash I. SVN lock. Also implement, no, this is not LTO, no, improved, or maybe blame. So what I do is, before I touch this, I think I touched this recently. Where would this even be? Here. And so 9.7, so this and that revision 9.49, SVN lock, what did we do there? Improve to also wrap CPP, maybe one is CPP. This might be the difference. Oh yeah, CPP wrapper. But CPP doesn't need lip. Why did I left? Maybe I left it in here for readability, but yeah, don't really need that there. And maybe it's also a tiny little bit nanosecond faster of not having to potentially match there more. But this now, so this is I, so basically we want to copy that. And also, unfortunately, this kind of operation can easily cause new regressions because something might have worked accidentally or something. So as we make this only include, or you know what, let's make this include, then this two include things are below, and I leave this here in brackets for better debuggability of similar stuff. So this is only include, and this is lib, so this should be only lib user stuff fine tuned z. And so this is the last, this is only the last, but would this work with, it doesn't match until the end though. You know what we better do? I think I'll reverse that and don't save it, I think, because the issue is, this would automatically work for the case that this transform doesn't end, or does end with lib64 and lib32 and stuff, which some architectures might be using. So to play safe and not to break something, which probably most likely if you touch something that works, then usually it causes some regression. But anyway, I think I remove that for, that should just be dash I. Maybe at the time of writing I thought, so I can be focused. Maybe at the time of writing I thought that leaving that in here is nice for debugging that, but whatever. So what we probably better do is make an additional transform. So leave this as it is. And add here a second, although does it, so transform Z, and so, or maybe okay, let's go for like readability first and not put this into the same SED expression, and substitute everything. Let's draft that. I usually like to draft stuff. So we have here like I or L, I intentionally don't, I think this might cause, oh no, this even works. So this would be user lib, and what we want here is lib64. So substitute, so basically what we want is not ending with lib64. So substitute lib64, but so basically, or actually like ending with lib, because otherwise it's a little bit hard to write this regular expression to make our life, and I think we have again some Unicode garbage in there because it's our life. Am I the only one who has Unicode garbage problems, or do others have the same stuff? SED what? Yeah, here was the garbage, my fast typing around types or something. Maybe also use comma, because otherwise this pass stuff is always harder to read. You can use, as I said in the previous video, use any delimiter, nearly any. So not end of line, and so substitute everything ending with lib in the actual lib prefix. This is probably the most readable. And so that would be libdir. So for to test this further, so this would be libdir equals like user lib whatever 64. And from that we would need the last path. That would be substitute all the beginning away of that, in case you were wondering, and then this would be the final stuff of that, and then we also need single quotes to have this expanded. And obviously this would previously be prefixed with some root stuff, but that is not a part of this expression. So I think this probably should work, so that we could add that here, like SED and this fine stuff. Probably this should work, single quotes. Now we can use single quotes here because this is expanding in the surrounding double quotes. And so for better readability, or in general, we let's just leave it in there and run it always. So yeah, let's always run it, even if it's lib, because why not? Doesn't matter. It's replacing not lib to lib. It's instead of a conditionalizing this on if lib dir not equal that. Yeah, I guess that probably should work. We probably can give it a try with flag and see if that fixes the thing. So welcome to Jamaican. What's your favorite x86 architecture? There's something present in the architecture would like to see in others. I would say in the meantime RISC-V. RISC-V is really nice, clean, nice and clean. I made this previous video, instruction set architectures, comparing them. This also changed over the years. By the way, how fast is this video preview? Because my preview is like previewing in 5. But yeah, we have a load. In case you're wondering why is this bloody YouTube stream so laggy, we have a load of 64. I would estimate of only 38. No, okay, maybe. Because we're building Firefox twice for Spark and MIPS. So previously, like a decade ago when I was young and naive, I would have maybe answered PowerPC, because that simply worked the best for me, and I was running this as a daily server and workstation when I was a student in university with this IBM RS6000 P50 server, previous video, and an iBook, which I don't have anymore, but then the G4 Cube in previous videos, and then the G5. And PowerPC, in all the T2 building history, PowerPC usually had the least regressions, was usually just working for the most part. I had the least problems overall. However, now that a decade later I've done more assembly and looked closer to the instruction set architecture, it's not as clean as I would like in terms of previous videos of formatting this instructions. It's much more irregular than I would have liked. And it's still good. Also, MIPS is MIPS doesn't, also this didn't apparently fix something. Unrecognized command, I'm not doing it hosted. What? What did we broke now? Maybe we oversubstitute something. Did we broke something? But anyway, MIPS is not as good as I thought from university and stuff. But this is also between theory and praxis then, and just the last decade I also learned for position independent code for dynamic object or shared and dynamic object dynamic objects, MIP64 is not as amazing. It doesn't have indexing relative to what was it, instruction pointer, MIPS position in the, was it independent code. I think this was somewhat inefficient. It doesn't have some addressing modes, like maybe relative to instruction pointer and stuff. And also a previous video, I probably mentioned this in some video, it's not as nice to virtualize, or in general kernel programming. Well, it's somewhat easy because MIPS has really hard-coded kernel segment stuff, and this is also not really, this is not a nice, yeah, so this is probably seen in some previous bootloader and MIPS kernel video of mine. This is hard-coded of kernel segment stuff. You can't change this, so what this means is if you run in kernel mode on MIPS, like your operating system kernel, then so this user map and mapped means going through the memory mapped unit, and the special segments of addresses of 80 million or so, you get the idea, hex. Kernel segment 0 is hard-coded to kernel, unmapped cached, so unmapped meaning it's physical addresses, so this is like physical address 0 here, anywhere going here to from here to 512, and this is a little bit unflexible. This is, I think, like nearly no other architecture has that, so given that, I would say as much as with the Octane stuff, when I got the Octane, I thought MIPS, like school book of university risk stuff, but yeah, this is a little bit hard-coded and also prevents easy virtualization, so many other risks are much better to virtualize there due to the non-map, because you can't like run the kernel, you probably need special hardware similar to x86, special built-in hardware support for that virtualization address stuff, if they would not. But yeah, maybe this is when was probably MIPS is super old, done in the 80s, right? MIPS either Wikipedia, so it's, yeah, if you would do this today, you wouldn't do that. And 80, 85, 35 years ago, certainly in the 80s, but this was also close to, I mean, people already knew memory management unit, and it's in my opinion, not really a good reason except simplicity, and it's, yeah. But yeah, long story short, nowadays RISC-V is not because it's the new and whatnot, but simply because it's nice and open, and otherwise probably PowerPC, maybe then PowerPC Spark, MIPS in that area in this order. Certainly the SGI machines look cooler, the Spark machines are better Linux kernel supported, but who wouldn't go for the cooler look than for the better Linux kernel support, obviously. But anyway, we soon need to do our own thing. So what exactly, so we apparently you probably, I should have tested this, what we did, so I pre-tested this makeopt, maybe, so we did, I don't have this in GCC wrapper debug, probably we might mangle there something with over, do we over, did you mean if hosted no standard, what is happening here, so we have, this is what our wrapper does, shared no stdlib, why is it no stdlib, maybe we or here's some libs, but lib64 user, what is this here, tools lib64, but we only translate user stuff, not really sure what we regressed now. No std, where did this, maybe we broke something so much that it knows things it doesn't have a C library and built some freestanding stuff, but okay, it has here, no actually it has here stdc++ libgcc. Shared stdlib. What does it say? It says no std. But actually, it has a no std. How did that get in there? I don't. Yeah, so much to attempting to fix it quickly. Well, we could see what happens with script setup. And so this Firefox build that is Spark. So what did we do for Spark? For Spark, we, yeah, Spark doesn't have a JIT anyway. So let's see what we get for Spark now, because we still have this room heater running. VGA here, wake up. Precious rsync of all of that. Of course, without password, because. And yeah, we get this rsynced. Also, I slightly wonder with another. Nice, this is rolling shutter stuff, but whatever. What did it? Did it rsync something, or which is even the? Yeah, so there we got the browser rsync. Change root here. I think from the last time, the GTK demo probably did work. Whatever is going on there with this. Also, we have a trick point here. And let's see what happens with Firefox. If this sandbox stuff magically makes some stuff disappear, or it's loading, it's still loading. Fingers crossed, thumbs crossed. And we registered something. IPC received, IPC close. Graphic critical error, IPC close, abnormal shutdown. GFX, I think it changed slightly, IP also, IPDL protocol error, it's slightly different, a tiny bit, not much different, but nah. That is really unfortunate though, as you probably can imagine. So yeah. Whatever is there in misalignment of that building, that so much to that efforts well spent of not having a working Firefox. Probably I also stop then at this point, maybe test Octane again to see what happens there, but because it probably also, it's still building, whereas even this is there. So crypt setup also, so now it fails differently. So apparently we have really broken something very well there. This is where we test stuff. Parse low, so what could we have? Parse config, what did we break here? Include lib something. I mean, that probably should var append filter stuff ending. Ah, you know what? We should match here more. So this lib stuff could certainly match more. Also, right. So this one, we want to match this only for. And we also want. Wait a second, do we because if we with other like no stdlib and stuff, we certainly don't want to transform that in some way, and also not passes that are correct, so like maybe we link something 32-bit for grub or something booting, and so we for sure want to lock this to starting this op user whatever stuff and not to this root. So either we copy this in full. Why, by the way, did I reframe from editing that here? This R path of, what did I say earlier, of not all right, probably of of doing too much in one expression, huh? Also, you know what? This is actually not too difficult to do in one expression. Let's make those two expressions and then it probably should match and work properly. So let's copy this in full and make the last I, because we have the I down there. So that would be that. That should be pretty similar. SED, okay, this says, okay, rpath link. So we obviously don't need rpath link stuff here. So let's or, let's remove that. So then these two should be identical, which is good for debugging. Once for GCC and once for CPP alone. And this one is L or dash L or. I just leave this here for debugging, doesn't matter that this is a single character class now. Or rpath link stuff. This, all this stuff, user lib. Oh, right, ah, it's down. I said so much to. But you know what? Let's anyway. Unfortunately, we need this twice. Darn, this is probably why. Anyway, let's. So then end. If this ends with this, so the third is lib or include. Because as I said, it could already be ending this. So yeah, if this ends with lib, then where do we have to expand this? This is probably should expand, huh? So then this should be lib dir. And how you over a decade create regular expressions that are unreadable. I guess that should expand. Unfortunately, we need this twice now, which theoretically, you know what, let's just copy this here for now, because we need it twice for if it doesn't end in lib. And we need that. So yeah, probably I should commence this. So transform non-trans, also maybe what is it, hard-coded. Okay, we have this already here. So package config and other output or hard-coded configure assumptions do not include the destir. We need to adapt this. So lib ending in just lib at libdir, any lib ten lib z, and includes through GCC and CPP, comma 2, maybe that is somewhat. Let's see what we get now. Probably in the meantime, Firefox is of course finished. Let's see, the Octane probably should fully boot. I pulled the cable out. Should we test? Okay, maybe we should test. We streamed long enough. Can also do that. Yeah, probably I need to walk around so to get the power cable back in. No, no, we have that in the room. So here, that actually is an octane, in case you're wondering. That should actually fully boot as it did previously. Okay, this still fails, cannot create executables. We probably mangled something completely. So yeah, the longer you fiddle with your regular expressions, the more you break them, apparently. Also, yeah, there is our process octane Linux booting then. And while that is booting, let's do here, finish this flag. This probably, as it doesn't work right, or maybe we just echo what could be, or we check the config log for what does it complain. Here, unterminated S command of something, so sure enough we broke that. So of course, without this large oversized YouTube font thing, it probably would be slightly easier for me too, although besides it's also a little bit hidden behind something for you. Would probably be slightly easier for me to debug that with a slightly smaller font for better readability too. So include, wait a second, we can remove there here more. I forgot to remove here. Apparently include user opt something. Include from so much to also. I didn't rewrite. It could be this here then though. Because let's hope this irritated. Actually, I thought I pressed this was copy and paste this with tmux with new lines of that fun stuff. Yeah, so it cannot. Let's see, is there still something? Yeah, but debugging this is obviously not the very greatest fun. L2, actually, maybe we should check if this expanded correctly. Oh, what is this filter? This is readable, thank you very much. SEDE, so is it even on camera? Hopefully it doesn't, somewhat on camera. SED something substitute L. Path link user slash or slash user opt lib crypto setup equals crypto setup. What? There probably something strangely substituted. /1/root here, I think. Was there not just an ampersand? There is, what is it, 2 libdir. No, let's run this here with set x and better see. Better see what is expanding there. While let's log in there. And so yeah, this is what we expanded here while we logged in there. So GNU org something. Yeah, this debugging this regular expression expansion stuff is certainly not for the lighthearted. Well, for a quick start, I could Let's think. So this, I think this has a chance to expand this lip deer. So wait a second, why is here? User opt include. Doesn't look too bad. We could. Let's test you one by one. Let's comment this out for a second. This, of course, will not fix this, but just to see if. This is anyway only. Can also continue this on the couch with whatever. We can also. The only thing we were interested here is whether Firefox works. So mount this and rsync that. What this build even flag without half of the fixes applied. Fun fact. Alright, by the way, maybe in the meantime we don't even need some of these patches anymore now that GCC is better, this root support. Anyway, so of course tiny, yes I know. Zoom on a little bit. Most important anyway is only whether it freaking works, not what the text is written there. So anyway, so with this line commented out it works, and let's see. So this wait a second, I commented this also wrong out though, to be honest. This was slightly stupid. Anyway, let's see with this line. If this still builds, and then no data available, what? Why does it say no? Whatever that is, maybe some protocol disagreement of. Anyway, this is not whatever that is not about. So bind mode all the stuff again because we had rebooted. Devproc this root, devproc this. So this might be all. Wish us luck. GTK 3 demo just to test that all the other infrastructure stuff still works. Nothing worse than GTK stuff fails already. But yeah, how long? This is cold load from rotating magnetic storage. In case you were wondering how long that takes. Also, Firefox, no illegal instruction. Okay, this illegal instruction, so it throws some exceptions that is not JIT, because now this should be disable JIT. Yeah, didn't fix the thing so much to that shoot there that probably. So this illegal instruction most likely a assertion exception thrown of something. Okay, this expression is already broken, apparently. Maybe 1, 2, 3, what? And we didn't even change that much. Oh, I also didn't see that the most. So much to. This should not have changed that much. But so much to just changing your regular expression a little bit. Also did this load the backtrace or. Yeah, it's libxul, and I think it should theoretically be possible to Yeah. Someone thinks this is an intentional trip there, but so. But yeah, programming stuff. This should also simply print what's wrong and not throw an exception in such a way that it doesn't print anything. It's hilarious. But someday, maybe not soon, I really stop with this Firefox stuff. We fix, you know, those other two issues and then we call it a day. At least I think it worked somewhere. Well, very theoretically, but I should also, what time is it, 2030? Did I... Did the UltraSpark not fully shut down? This is also a new thing, maybe. Theoretically, you know what, let's plug in... Did I rebuild? Or maybe we also... I should also go home eventually. Because I wanted to test that Firefox, I imported the Solaris. Yeah, we also need to rebuild that, unfortunately. Because I would want to test if the imported Solaris Big Indian Skia blending patches also fix. So I pressed again something stupid here. Whether this fixes the. Yeah, maybe we test this. Maybe we boot the G5 also, because you can never boot all platforms. So when we build this, also wait a second, theoretically we could, let's. Firefox, as this options didn't hit a effect anyway, I guess we want to test the sandbox on on Power PC 64. So yeah, let's share, like, and subscribe. Wait 20 minutes while we also debug here this regular expression. Let's see, there was a new comment. Welcome Danny, back from work. That is amazing. So back to work here. Hope your work was okay. Everyone is healthy, by the way, in general. And enjoys the Sunday here together live on this channel. We wanted to. We wanted to tame this regular expression. You know what, we could actually debug it like this. This is also the fun of echo user lib64 into that. Oh, we had SED already in there. Fun fact. SED. User lib. I mean, at least it doesn't error out. What else do we have here? User lib. So root, we could. Set here root equals user toolchain, whatever, just to test this. And lib, so actually we could test, so this should append, that and actually root. Oh, wait a second. So this doesn't, because this is like this, because no. Wait a second, we have here, what do we have here? Substitute. Ah, this is just substituting multiple occurrences. Unterminated S command. Because. Of. AVX. Toolchain, 2, 3. Maybe we. What does it character on? Maybe I deleted there some. Yeah, counting this stuff now. Is there some regular expression debugging thing? Probably there is. theoretically, we could revert this and redo this and more carefully, step by step, test that. Oh, wait a second, this didn't build. Why not? Ah, darn. This is over. Okay, fine. This doesn't build because it has this broken stuff. That was very clever of us. Yeah, let's just revert this mess and build Firefox with a non-reverted mess. Let's gradually redo what we did, because there's never something like redoing those regular expressions. So that means include, we don't need lib there. That is deleting that. Maybe this time we test each of those each time while we guru meditate over the rest of the regular expression. And by the way, fun fact, so this is just, I think this is, we can clean this up. We don't need this here multiple times. So that, for example, because this is just unifying multiple of these occurrences, and for performance and readability, we don't need to do this multiple times. So let's do this once. And then var append the rest of it. And so let's see. So this fails probably the way it was failing. I'm right now only refactoring that this time, hopefully without less breakage. And include lib something something. So I would hope that this still works. And then if that still works, we try one more time. So what we wanted to do is, by the way, is there anything we overlooked? Probably not. So this is still building flag. So what maybe also could be, oh, wait a second. All right, we wanted to factor this also. Then let's next factor. What did I last do? Okay, that. Let's factor that out, which basically is this include thing. Include or lib. And copy this include thing from the CPP thing, which is exactly the same. There. And so we have here left dash L, rpass stuff, user, lib, root. So this should hopefully also still work. Actually, flagpole's surprisingly long. So, Okay, this probably fails the same way as it doesn't fail in configuring stuff. It probably is quite fine. We have some soft drink here, maybe. And we have not a paid advertisement, though. Right, I could theoretically already plug in the G5 and boot it. that we have at least one successful thing, so this still fails probably the same, of which is not the worst thing of refactoring our code. This time step by step. So what I wanted to initially this was we had here this, and this is, by the way, old tabs, looks like old tabs, except so what I said we need is ending in lib without the prefix, which I hope, or does this expand to, you know what, now I know what was the issue. And nobody probably found it unregulated TV station, yeah. Anyway, I hope it pays well. Also, why does we are in grub password for full disk encryption, and due to not calling into open firmware that is fans in hyperventilation mode. And yep, some precious G5. And then, so because the issue is this ampersand that expands to something, of course, this is, so we need, if we want a, does this work? So this works, so much to that, or we use another delimiter here anyway. I mean, usually, why did I not? All right, I didn't use comma because here we have a comma. That is why I didn't use a comma. Anyway, then let's make this work with this time after we finally understood why this wasn't working previously. Was let's escape, oops, escape that, and this was supposed to be libdir. Of nah. Libdir, where did I prototype this? Here. I mean, not that this would be the most difficult to retype, but nonetheless, reusing is always good. So has this a chance to work? We add this to this variable. And SEDEL. So this should end in lib. And then we actually add the actual libdir. And we only run this again. Okay, this is actually translated there. So for anything else, if this still matches with this previously not ending in lib, then we use it as it. I think that probably could work. The only change, as far as I see, is that we escaped the ampersand there. Let's see if that fixes the thing. Happy to hear that it pays the bills. And okay, no such fine SEDs. That is also not a good start if it already SED something, something, no such file or directory. Nah. Did we not only? Or is here now some libdir the mean, let's see if for test if z works. Can never test enough regular expression building stuff here. So did I, maybe I earlier pulled here the cable, something maybe. Not sure, also slightly loose though. Probably I, or, oh no, maybe it was. Okay, this still doesn't work. So multiple things apparently break. So apparently maybe this libd thing, so maybe two, is this also doing something? So yeah, this kind of regular expression setup is hard at the border of, well, but these are the systems, well, this is just like the domain-specific languages, like regular expression that Computer Society built for stuff like this, well, sort of, kind of, anyway. Oh, come on. What else did we, or is this, or does both not? I mean, without this, it should be the same, no? Or did we copy and paste here any other? We can also already start X. Maybe only TWM because it's also test install. Nothing better than some test installs. Always with TWM. No, we apparently really broke them. Maybe our copy and paste. Copy and paste too much too. Darn, copy and pasting in Tmux. What else have we broken here? That is hilarious. Or is here some 100, is it 159, is this one, what else could be broken here? I mean, basically, let's, oh, this is also not Vim, let's, nah. Use a Riemann's editor. And does this hopefully, maybe we should actually check if that step by step. Also, yeah, this Firefox is obviously still building, so we can still finalize our amazing regular expression construction there. Okay, this is, so probably we copy and pasted there some really strange character somewhere. So what we actually wanted long time ago is this. And let's maybe, or theoretically shouldn't be, libdir, let's save this and hope for the best. Yeah, but recurring theme, invisible Unicode character stuff is certainly pretty annoying. Not only when you type on the call, hey, now it works, yoohoo. Crypt setup. So I guess, all right, previously we also nicely commented this, right? So, okay, fine, maybe not with kill buffer. So that is merge multiple slashes path separators. So by the way, one thing I always separators is somehow I often misspell. Separator, but maybe I got it right. If not, leave it in the comments below. Translate all non this road this trailing lib and correct to libdir. Oops. Any other non this deer keep any other then and translate includes two, a little bit many regular expressions, but yeah, I'm doing. Okay, crypt setup apparently still fails. Let's see if we messed something up or flag at least builds. Of course, theoretically, as usual with this kind of operation, there at the heart of the system, it's always not the worst idea to actually rebuild everything like what we do on a weekly basis anyway. But yeah, non-visible, also flex still builds. And let's debug what is going on with crypt setup. Wait a second, this is not flex still builds, but it still builds after we fixed it, obviously. Let's see what is this. Still some cross dlib whatever. It only looked similar, but might be some tiny little... I mean, it's similar of pthread, but... Yeah. Crypt setup eval debug of, so this is being run, and so this is user source, so this is copy, so this is already supplying that though, which is not the right deer. Where does it get this from? So here we have the issue that it somehow currently maybe passes in, or when are the filters run copy or run filters first, it copies this stuff and then it runs our filters on top of it. But yeah, it's similar but not entirely the same. I wonder where it's coming from though, so we need to work around this somehow differently, because why should two build arrows be the same? And that is in... I don't know whether this is in, source. Actually, so it has here user lib64, and this comes from JSON clib, so they are apparently wrong. This is where this garbage is coming from. Why did CJSON stuff got this wrong? Root var adm log JSON C of libdir. Oh darn, this is some shit. Maybe this is even in the wrong directory then. Maybe this is installing wrong way. JSON C of, yeah, of course this is installing in the wrong directory. Mine rf -r build mip64, the more you debug and stuff the better. JSON C, and Firefox is still building even on a epic thread ripping AMD Ryzen. Tar download mirror JSON C Let's find the bloody CMake thing for Z. Lib suffix or required, what does it? Libdir, install libdir of library destination. Maybe this will do. Probably had this already somewhere. No. Prefix libdir, here's full libdir. What, each package is using another name? Nah. Which one was it even? Compits? Nah, fine, whatever. JSON C, JSON desk of var append. CMake opt. If it is CMake opt, I hope it's CMake opt. CMake. What even was this of grep? Probably this was slightly different of install. Full libdir of install libdir. Probably has a chance to work. Let's give that a try. JSON C. Was it JSON C? Maybe it was. Maybe it wasn't. Maybe it was. So yeah, Firefox still building. Hopefully this, yeah, I think it's already in some final Rust and LTO and whatnot stuff. No, darn. Thank you very much for that. Maybe install targets. CMake install, where is this? Ah, here's libdir of Unix or libdir, CMake full libdir. Exec prefix is, nah. Install full libdir. Not sure if that, let's see if that still needs a prefix. Let's just see if it magically works or. Yeah, but also this modern build systems, right? They don't even get this dir and libdir suffix stuff right. That did something. Let's hope we are lucky enough. But yeah, time wasted with other foreign build systems, a recurring theme here. JSON C of. No, but this is not correct, unfortunately. Install prefix. Somehow I have the feeling this is this might encode the wrong path if we use this with the root prefix. Maybe this, or maybe is it Maybe I should check what it is substituting in this. Okay, let's first see if it installs this in the right. Yeah, this is at least the correct libdir. RM this, because now we had it twice, and let's maybe also Firefox finished, yeah, then we can sync it to the G5. And JSON C, is it package, where would this be of package config in? So yeah, it's substituting that, but the question is, what is it use, whether does it only have CMake or so yeah, it sets actually libdir to CMake install full libdir. So here you have it, it sets this directly. The only question is if I mean, first of all, this probably has the wrong prefix. Pair build MIPS, it shouldn't have the whole this root prefix, but what do they know about cross compilation? User lib 60, did I build this already? JSON package config JSON libdir of yeah, prefix. So yeah, this is not really correct. So probably we, oh no, I deleted this already. We could, oh, this is the one I see. If it has any kind of testdir provisioning, or maybe not. Yeah, modern build systems. Maybe we leave it like this. It probably fixes that not in a pretty way. MIP 64 job crypt setup. So install binary dir destination, install public health destination, install prefix. Yeah, somehow this is not amazing. This find whatever other stuff to do. So then we also fixed script setup on MIP 64, which also could have failed on others, by fixing JSON C of fixed JSON C to install and correct libdir. And the other is develop GCC parse config of improved non this root translation to potentially and the correct libdir. Probably that probably gets the idea. So yeah, G5. Here we have it. Which keyword I have to also have this, obviously. We talked fixed code so long that it's already suspended. Oops, and now I somehow full screen set. Certainly I don't want to full screen set. So this would be, and yes, it's tiny, but that's what it is, also tiny for me, I want to go home. New, what do we have, new 32, I guess, should that be file lib 64. No, anyway, it's rsync. So this is rsync. Oh, yeah, right, I had hit 2. So lib power pc 64. Rsync all of this to new, maybe without delete to preserve our precious network is unreachable. This stuff. Yeah, also this is some strange, not sure if it's a hardware failure. Sometimes this G5 doesn't have link when it comes up, then replugging the cable helps, unfortunately. Or it could be simply that I plugged in the network and the Ethernet cable into maybe the Ethernet 0 is labeled Ethernet 2 and Ethernet 1 is labeled Ethernet 2 or something. It's tool off. No, we still don't have links, so then probably it was this coming up with no link issue. Then Ethernet 0 might be labeled 1. Let's see if that... What? No link? Ah, we are not in run level 3 or something. Now we have links, so rsync. Now that works. So yeah, I was thinking that fun stuff. Maybe in the future I should network mount the stuff more, like mounted NFS, and I don't need this rsync and just can run and run it. But somehow I seen in last year's video, NFS also had some regressions, didn't just work as smooth and easily anymore. So bind mount root proc dev this change root gtk3 demo just in case. Yeah, good that we tried this. etc post install shared mime info. Try that again, because not that we just get frustrated and already depressed with Firefox failing when it's just shared mime info stuff. Oh, this also was wrong. Yeah, still I can see missing error quarker. Is that a thing? Query there. No such for the directory. Okay, dir, rmdir. Oops, mdir query gtk demo. Nah. Whatever, should we try Firefox without that failing? Not really, whatever we miss here now. Hey, it even comes up, at least some success. And maybe it fixed the colors, I would say, the patches I imported. Let's, the fonts is, maybe it crashes with the fonts. Let's try to also hear warnings there. You can also obviously want to see that a little bit better, right? So the fonts is as usual, and then I... It would also be cool if you want to help, if you want to debug there some MIPS and Spark issues, because there's only so much I can do. And but there is share, like, and subscribe and Patreon. this with this. Oh, no, this demo works. This demo was just fonts, apparently, because none of the stuff works. So Firefox, the final test. So I think the colors are more correct with the Solaris patches. Yeah, this also. So yeah, this menu previously completely garbled. So at least there's hope for the PS3. Okay, this is you can't make this stuff up. Not everything is fixed. The web page is fixed, but this icon stuff is not. What was it? Maybe nothing is fixed. So much to importing others. People's, hey, hello, which is also TWM. I'm not the greatest fan of that. Let's visit some websites like our own. And also probably that doesn't even work because obviously how to even, or probably not the greatest fan of TVM. Suspenses, control set, background, VI, etc, resolve. Oops. And see what happens here with our own websites. That last time was already enough for this graphics. So what did I import the Solaris patches for when they do nothing? So but you know what, maybe it doesn't, as this doesn't work, maybe it doesn't set some big engine thing correctly that those patches don't apply, but yeah, so much to importing random. But you know what? I think the patches must do something because this menu works. Otherwise, this menu wasn't working at all, to be honest. So I think the patches do a little, but not like everything. Also, I clearly wanted to type this slightly differently. But yeah, browsing the internet 2.5 gigahertz, although it's dynamically reclocking, so maybe the doesn't have the lowest latency, but yeah, in case you were wondering, this is a decade old WordPress garbage. Oh, no, you get the idea. So what I clicked, did I click? Maybe I clicked. Hello, can we load? Is it busy? But yeah, here is also some title RGB. I mean, what is so difficult? And this is hilarious. Well, importance of Solaris patches still doesn't work. You would think with these patches it works, but in general, what is so difficult to write proper engine is neutral. Anyway, it's not more broken and it works a little bit, but yeah, somehow I was hoping for a perfect fix, but it's apparently shut down. There, at least we did some stuff, including library passes, also some not entirely amazing. I have MIPS, little endiness on MIPS, MIPS 32R1 or 2 or something to test. Maybe I try that another day. Anyway. I hope you learned something. I hope you found this useful. Don't forget to like and subscribe. We certainly have way more patches here to clean up. Maybe I should actually, because of this Firefox patches, it would of course be really nice if that freaking would work. And so these are those here. Maybe this Spark. How many patches in the meantime did we accumulate for all this stuff? It's like, yeah, that much stuff. Maybe this mod's big Indian is not set correctly for our build, which might also explain the strange menu fonts. It's big Indian is Yeah, maybe this is defined. I mean, we had, this is already in the previous video that there's something wasn't set, so apparently there's still more broken. Anyway, that's it for today. I have to go and I hope learn something, and it's anyway, yeah, so much time. This is a crazy amount of time for, I would have really hoped. Well, it works on the PowerPC 64, but that it doesn't on the Spark 64 and MIP 64, so it builds now, but nah. But nah, also so much to, so much to the state of non-x86 stuff. Anyway, thanks for watching. I hope to see you next time. We will really move on. Well, mostly we did this for you. Not only I need a cross-compiled thing for x86, but also you playing along at home. And then, what did you got there? Not allowed GCC. This might be fixed. Do you start a new build from scratch? I had something broken there with the usual cleanup stuff. And did I commit this already? Maybe I didn't commit this already. Or did I GCC conf of merge scandi? I think this was log revision that. And yeah, let's commit this. Partially reverted that we need. What do we have there? This is. Target liberty and that's probably good enough. So this probably should fix this. I run into this myself, bootstrapping this MIP64. But yeah, recurring theme. We also saw MIPS, so this we can scratch. This is some tiny. Yeah, all the tiny stuff also. Here's some minutes, there's some minutes. ARM64, we probably. There. Yeah. I think this probably should work, but do I have a full ARM64 build or did I delete that? Alright, this was also, you know what, clean up build ARM64 because we built this with some wrong prefix. Anyway, let's fully retest this, especially with our just now altered and improved stuff here. The Graver, I still have a Ultra 5 to give away that nobody picked up yet without the memory though, in case you want that from the little giveaway last year. And yeah, if you want this for Spark work, I mean it's 270, I think 270, just regular PC compatible EDO RAM something whatever offset should be cheap on eBay. Yeah, always rebuilding, especially after such also rebuilding. And then what? No such full directory. What have we? File exist. What? Oh, why is this R? Because I made this is failing my own stuff. This was for when I had some typo from the other ARM64 videos. That fun. stuff or some link and prevent your whole build. Yeah, eventually, now that T2 is in such an amazing shape that we can cross-compile really a lot, even if the segmentation falls due to the imperfection of the upstream projects. Maybe it would be nice to fix a couple of, not many, only one or two. Or it's like, yeah, this is harmless. This is just like reading a file or including some generic file that's not there. It's like, yeah, theoretically, would be nice to fix, but yeah, whatever. Anyway, I gotta go. Hope you learned something. Don't forget to like, subscribe, Patreon and stuff for all this time spent on it. Probably next, what I can test, because Fridays for Future, not wasting energy having the G5 running the whole night, I can leave it off and just compile this. So because I'm, except would also be nice to send something upstream to get my name into really everything. But for that, I could compile test this and like add here plus, like add here one more line and just see if this still builds this error. Still or error no CPU. And also means theoretically similar to here. And that would be here, Big Onion. Is it the same file? This is all the same file. Also, yes, this is code of bytes popping this stuff before and after. This is so really hilarious. 39, this is what I meant with not the most amazing. And let's error out here, because due to the Unicode stuff from the other video, I have the impression that there's something wrong with this configure stuff. It obviously wasn't correctly set for the ICU stuff, or not set or something. And maybe that is also the same issue here, why these patches don't even have an effect then, or why we have other random breakage for other stuff. So job one Firefox, and then I can actually, well, compile test what's going on there without having the G5 running, because this kind of stuff I need to debug in the build. Anyway, so yeah, that's it for today, and I hope to see you next time. Oh, did I?